Sri Gopa Kumar said. Bowing down and touching his feet, I humbly said, Lord, you know everything. Then Narada smiled and, glancing at Uddhava, spoke. O Uddhava, he was born as a cowherd's son on Govardhan Hill. Very restless, he has been searching place after place for something even those like you and me cannot attain. Not finding it, his heart is filled with pain and grief. You are overcome with kindness for the people there. Why did you not enlighten him? Sanatana Goswami explains that the phrase, the people there, means the people of Braj. His home is very far away, and his happiness is also very far from us. We pray for them, but they are very difficult for us to attain. Sanatana Goswami explains that the home here is the realm of Goloka, which is far from Vaikuntha, and which, because it is very exalted, is difficult to attain. The happiness there is the happiness of seeing the son of Nanda and enjoying pastimes with him. Even though Narada and Uddhava are eternal associates of the Lord, they still pray to attain that realm and that happiness. Uddhava said, He was born in the land of Braj, and there he was a cowherd boy. His faith is placed in the worship of Gopal. He is more exalted than we. Narada eagerly and happily embraced him and said, Teach him how to quickly attain his desire. Uddhava replied, O great sage, I am a Kshatriya by birth. I should not teach when you are present. Narada laughed and said, Even in Vaikuntha, you think you are a Kshatriya? Srila Sanatana Goswami explains that the castes exist only in the material world, not in the spiritual world, where everything is eternal and full of knowledge and bliss. Uddhava smiled and said, What I say is not my idea. Our Lord has not rejected his status as a Kshatriya. As he does there, so here he also protects the principles of religion by following the restrictions of household life, conquering his enemies, worshipping the elders and the Brahmins, and acting piously, and in other ways also. Sanatana Goswami explains that the there is the Dwarka in the material world. Some of the Lord's other religious actions, beginning with rising for Brahma Muhurta, are described in the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. With these words, Narada's heart was overcome with joy. Filled with wonder, laughing, jumping up and down, and crying out, he spoke. Ah, the wonder of the glory and sweetness of the Lord's pastimes! Ah, the depth of faith in him alone, held by his servants who are like him! I have seen great wonder. The Supreme Lord, who stays in a place above even Vaikuntha, enjoys pastimes in the material world to please they who are dear to him. Persons like me become bewildered when we see the Lord's pastimes. Are we in the material world or in the Dwarka of Vaikuntha? You have love and devotion for the Lord's lotus feet, and the Lord, who loves his devotees, fulfills their desires. Your actions have nothing to do with living in Vaikuntha, nor do they have anything to do with the material opulences or with material friends and relatives. You are always humble, and that helps your love and devotion for the Lord. He enjoys pastimes as if he were an ordinary person, and that helps the exchange of love between him and his devotees. That love makes the Supreme Lord act as an ordinary person that is the dear friend of his devotee. I glorify that seemingly ordinary relationship by which transcendental love for Krishna is manifest without awe and reverence. Sri Gopa Kumar said, Speaking these words, the sage became overcome with ecstatic love and fell silent. Seeing that I was unhappy, he began again to teach me. Sri Narada said, O beloved of Gopal Dev, O son of a Gopa, very far from here, a beautiful place named Goloka, the crown of all Vaikuntha planets, is splendidly manifest. Goloka's form is the beautiful land of Braj in the district of Mathura. Although the splendid city of Mathura is also there, Goloka cannot exist without its heart, the land of Braj, which begins with Vrindavan Forest. Because it is primarily a land of cows, Mathura is called Goloka. Although it is a secret place, it is famous everywhere. Sanatana Goswami explains that Goloka is a secret place because the Lord enjoys secret pastimes there. Goloka is attained only by one who follows the pure love the people of Braj feel for Krishna. Love like that never manifests when one sees the Lord's opulence, for that brings awe and reverence. That love is perfect when one thinks that the Lord is an ordinary person, one's life friend. That love is beyond the coverings of the material worlds. It is beyond the realm of Vaikuntha. This mutual love, as if they were ordinary persons, is very extraordinary. It is mixed with ordinariness, sweetness, wonder, and glory. His and their actions increase their love. That love is not possible in Vaikuntha, the realm of opulence. Ayodhya is like Vaikuntha, and Dwarka is even more opulent. Krishna has placed Goloka very far from these two places. Situated in the highest sweetness, his happy pastimes with the people there becomes perfect there, the proper place for them. I think that Lord Hari's most confidential feature is manifested there. The glory of Goloka, which is situated above Vaikuntha, and which is the crest jewel of all the worlds, is supreme. Who can describe the supreme and wonderful glories of Mathura Goloka, which is beyond the material worlds? Friend, listen. My restless tongue itches to speak. Now I will show you the jewel which I have long kept in the box of my heart.